There you go.
Oh, that's seen better days, hasn't it?
Yeah. Just a button back armchair. Let's get it inside and have a better look at it. Yeah.
Whilst its exact origins are unknown, this chair's traditional button-back style is inspired by one of the most famous English chair designs, the Chesterfield. The name is thought to derive from a commission by Lord Philip Stanhope, the 4th Earl of Chesterfield. He wanted somewhere for a gentleman to sit without putting creases in his suit, and the end result was the forerunner to the Chesterfield sofa.
So, what do you think?
Nice shape, that's about it.
That's about it, really.
As you know, I usually search out leather that looks like this, but it's too far gone, hasn't it?
Yeah. I notice there's a lot of splits. Mm. Where them splits are going to be almost impossible to repair.
Can you stitch this? Yes or no?
No.
There you go.
It just splits, so there's no point in trying to save something that's not savable.
No. So what I want to do is take it all off. What I want to use is a kilim or printed kilim type fabric on here.
Yeah.
And all the way around here. You can lose any of this button detail or add as much as you like. I'd rather less is more.
Right, okay.
To be perfectly honest with you. And a larger size button.
Okay, yeah.
In that kilim fabric there. And then on the sides, I want to do that in a colour that will work with the rest of this.
So we'll transform the chair completely then?
Completely. Basically what we bought is a shape.
Yeah.
We bought an option really to do something else with it. All right. Cool.
Okay.
I'll use it.
All right. Okay, cheers. It's quite easy to get it wrong. It's all right having these ideas in my head and Drew having these ideas, but actually putting that into practice and it looking right is very, very difficult.
With Drew gone, Craig gets to work. His first job is to completely strip the decades-old leather from the sides and back of the chair.
I don't know what's inside this now. It's a bit... There's a pencil, hey! And there's a bag in here. This gives us a bit of a clue. I don't even know what this is. The writing looks German. It's made by somebody called Fritz Schultz. Do you think that could be German? Oh, hang on, Leipzig. It's still sealed, the bag's still sealed. Wonder what was in that.
The unusual discovery could provide an insight into the provenance of Drew's chair and add some extra profit. Once the bulk of the leather has been removed, Craig is ready to start the lengthy process of completely reupholstering the chair.
Right, so that's the old seat, the old leather. That can go in the bin. What I need to do with this now is get a layer of polyester wadding over the top of this. So when the fabric's over the top of this, it allows fabric to move a bit easier, but also any imperfections in the surface will just be smoothed out by this.
Drew wants to make this chair stand out by replacing its tatty brown leather with a kilim fabric.
This is a fabric that's been chosen for the chair.
A colourful Middle Eastern material that features bold patterns in its design, it was often used by Victorians who came across it during their travels through the region. And it's going to be a headache for Craig.
Doing it in this fabric is not easy. Not only have I got to centralise it, but I put one wrong tack in or pull it wrong. It actually distorts the pattern. So I've got to make sure it's not only central, but pulled evenly sideways and back to front. So it is a tricky operation.
To ensure the pattern is lined up correctly, Craig uses upholstery skewers to hold it in position before beginning the first of hundreds of hand stitches.
So this edge here is where I'm going to stitch. What I do is when I'm going along here now, I work with the weave of the fabric so I can see whether it's straight. You can actually see that's curving up there. So what I do, I just work it with my thumb and you can see that straightens it up. So I do that as I go along. And then I wrap that round. Pull it. And that locks that off. Sewing this in is like all the other jobs in upholstery. It's tedious but necessary. I've done this front border wrong. I was concentrating on this bit here, which I'd matched, and not realised about that. Fortunately, I've got enough fabric, so I'm going to replace that front border there. Doesn't matter how good you think you are, I always make mistakes.
Confident he can reposition the fabric later, Craig continues with the exterior of the chair. He's using a red Hessian fabric that complements the Killam material.
Because I've already made a mistake on that front border, I'm going to be extra cautious with this. So I've got my thumb in there now. I'll turn it over. Get a tack in there. Turn it back again. It's a matter of checking it and rechecking it and rechecking it as you're going along. So that's the outside arm roughly tacked in place. So if I turn that over, what will happen with this now is if I just put tacks in that and pull this, this is what you get. So what you need to get a nice edge on that is some of this. It's called back tacking strip. So with this, get it in place at one end. Go a bit further along, pull it nice and tight.
The back tacking strip acts like a ruler and, once secured, will provide a straight edge to fold the seam over.
So what I'm doing now is I'm going to press this back tacking down with my finger, use my thumb here to feel the edge of the frame, and I'm literally just lining the back tacking up with the edge of the frame. Put another tack in here. Turn it back again. Now the back tacking's on there. If I pull this Hessian down, it gives a nice, straight, crisp edge along the top.
With the edges complete, the rest will need to be just as perfect to meet dealer Drew's high expectations.
Hello.
Hiya.
How are you doing?
Not bad.
Right then, I've come to see my leather chair.
Your leather chair?
Yes.
I think you're going to be disappointed with the leather
bit. Go on then, let's have a look. Oof, yes. Wow, well that's completely different. You've gone off script, haven't you, really?
Just a little. The button bit I got rid of and made it plain because the Killam's quite patterned anyway. I didn't want to sort of detract from that. And the red round here, I decided I had a couple of scraps, I put it on the front.
I think it's actually worked. I mean, there's modern interpretations of this, but to have it on a period chair, I suppose, gives it a little bit more of an oomph.
When it arrived, this chair was literally bursting at the seams, with its mouldy leather worn out and ripped. Now it's been completely transformed into a stylish armchair that retains the traditional character of the original design. The bold Killam fabric harks back to the days of the Victorian Grand Tour, and Craig has replaced the 80-year-old casters with new brass fittings. He's also solved the mystery of the chair's history.
While I was working on it, I found some bits inside it which are all German.
What is it?
It's moth and insect killer. And
these Leipzig?
These packets were inside it and they're from Leipzig. And then it's got the date, late 40s as well. So.
God. Well, that's a pretty cast iron provenance, isn't it?
Yeah, when you couldn't ask for better than that, could you?
It's a very, very nice job you've done. It's a completely different animal now, but I still think I could probably get 850, 895 for it, no problem. The quality is there, the colour's there, it's different, and you can actually say to people, well, it is a period chair underneath it. And when it comes right down to it, we're retailers, we're shopkeepers, we need things we can sell, and that's very saleable. It's lovely. Right, we'll have it picked up, get it in the shop.
Okay.
Thank you, mate.
All right, no problem. All right, cheers. He was happy with what I've done, the fact I went off on my own, did my own thing. He was happy with that. There's a little bit of money in this. Drew's saying he's going to get, what did he say, 850 or something like that for it. I think he'll get more than that for it. I mean, it's a good quality chair. Where else are you going to buy a chair like this? You know, you're not.